Good evening and welcome to ASO's Valentine's Day themed concert, Forbidden Dance. Tonight we're thrilled to perform alongside our friend and Polish classical guitarist, Krzysztof Meisinger, to present you with an audibly stunning interpretation of music of the 1920s and 30s and some of the most famous tango pieces ever written. Forbidden Dance is a reflection on love languages, exploring human concepts of love and romance, and the sometimes complicated, messy emotions associated, which have remained one of the primary inspirations for artistic expression throughout history. Tonight's performance is also inspired by the love and adoration of our friends Cindy and Larry with L.C. Matei. Not only their shared love for each other, but their adoration of the symphony, which was unparalleled. Cindy and Larry's love story here on Earth ended after Larry's courageous and valiant battle against COVID-19 in late 2020. Valentine's Day was always so special to them, and Cindy has graciously chosen to carry on their Valentine's Day tradition through a special sponsorship of tonight's concert. Thank you, Cindy, for sharing your Valentine's Day gift. This evening, I'd like to take a moment to thank our season sponsors and donors that include, but certainly are not limited to, Anonymous, Dr. Winston Wheel, the Thistlewood Foundation, Sir Chevrolet Cadillac, Ted and Cecilia Hoyt, MPW Properties, Billy and Cecile Tozin, Tides Medical, Blackett Coca-Cola Bottling, Vernon Moray, Jones Walker, Moss Motors, Planet Fitness, the Acadiana Advocate, Lamar Advertising, Right at Home, the Mills Family Foundation, and the Lafayette Visitors Enterprise Fund. Before we begin tonight's show, I take a moment to remind all of you that ASO is more than just concerts like tonight and events. We're an economic engine that has employed more than 2,600 musicians and teaching artists. We're an arts and culture anchor that has performed work for more than 127,000 patrons, and we've impacted more than 42,000 students. We help to make Acadiana a place where people want to live and play long after their workday has ended. We sincerely hope that no matter how you engage with ASO, that we continue to inspire you to learn, stay involved, and spread the word. Remember, if you hear something you like, okay to clap. If you have questions, it's okay to ask. If you have ideas about how we can be better, please let us know. We really like feedback. If you're worried about the dress code, never be. And we welcome you to come as you are or as you'd like to be. Without further ado, we give you Forbidden Dance.
Seriously, different religions, different group of people celebrate different occasions. We had Mardi Gras, being in Lent, people who went to celebrate Ramadan, Yom Kippur. But there are very few universal holidays we seem to agree how we're celebrating. And the Valentine Day, I think, is one of those. We are all hungry for affection, for attention, for love, sometimes difficult to describe all those feelings, and usually when the words stop, the music stops. So we have a selection of compositions for you that try to describe this sometimes difficult to define feeling of love and attention in the musical way, written for an instrument that probably is associated with one of the most romantic moments in the history of music. Most of the time, guitar accompanies a voice with lovely serenades and other intimate songs. This time we will have the plucked sound still coming from the guitar, but the melodic sound coming from a bolt instrument on stage, a lovely combination. A few words about our guest artists, three wonderful classical guitarists from my country of Poland, and so wife is here. There is a guitar magazine that goes out in London every month that is totally devoted to guitar playing, jazz, classical, pop, rock, everything. And they very often do those rankings of who is who, who is best, who is the most recorded. So there was a ranking recently published by this most prestigious magazine, and they had a 20 top classical guitarists ever. And Krzysztof was on the list. He's Spotify. The Spotify channel has more than 500,000 listeners all over the world. He gets about 30,000 hits every month. And he's hitting our stage today. So please give your warm welcome to Krzysztof Meisinger. pill. I'm so glad that I can be here with you in this very special day. When we are celebrating the day of love, of lovers, actually, Maestro really took care of me during those days I'm here, and let me tell you that your gumbos and crawfish dishes are really amazing. And if I could have one wish, I would stay a little bit longer to try them all. But of course, when I will be back in Poland, I will try to reconstruct them from my wife. we've welcomed you with the music of Gerardo Matos Rodriguez with a tango called La Compasita. Also Piazzolla, the composer of other pieces that we're going to play in the second half of this concert, described this one very tango as the ugliest tango ever written. But I enjoyed and I saw that you two are glad. Another pieces, two pieces we're going to play for you are movie pieces. We're going to play for you one piece which is not a tango exact, but it's a tango canción. The thing that was created by Carlos Gardel. This piece is called El Día que me quieras, and it was a song written to this to the movie at the same title, which I can translate as The Day You Love Me. And another piece is a piece by Ennio Morricone with the music written to the movie called Cinema Paradiso. And I really love this movie a lot. I saw it many times. And this time I'm going to tell you this story of what happened on there, together with this amazing orchestra with fantastic maestro. We will tell the story with the music only. So El Día que me quieras by Carlos Gardel and Suita Cinema Paradiso by Ennio Morricone.
Thank you.
just before the interval, we will play for you some music from Spain. Actually, it's quite very interesting composer. It's an Albanian who wrote most of his music for piano, but actually it's very recognized and very connected with the guitar. And when Francisco Parrega, the Spanish guitarist and composer, transcribed one of his pieces for the guitar and he played it for me, and he replied, "Well, I'm such sorry that I cannot write the music for the guitar because I don't know this instrument. But the only thing I can say is that my music of the guitar sounds the best." Really. And then we would like to play for you two pieces of him. First will be Malagueña from Sweden, Spider. Malagueña. That is from Malaga, from Sweden, Spider. And another piece is Asturias. And this is something special. Because when Isaac Albeniz wrote, he published the music and it was a great success. He became quite rich. But then other pieces he wrote, it was not such a big commercial success. So then he decided to rename the piece and sell it to another publisher. And then he called it Leyenda. And it was tremendous success. And then he said, okay, it worked twice. And the third time. And really, he really succeeded. And he sold it to another publisher. And it was called the Preludium. So the piece, the second piece we're going to play for you, is a three pieces in one. And you can choose which one you prefer. And we will make it. Thank you.
Thank you.
And now we would like to play for you some music of Arthur Piazzolla, which is a creator of the new tango form, let's say. And it's quite interesting that for me, actually, Arthur Piazzolla was not a great composer. He was one of those greatest artists of the 20th century. And in his music, we can find a lot of those very deep emotions, and he could recreate them into the music he felt. We're going to play for you five pieces of Arthur Piazzolla. The first one will be Antonio from Suda Toriana, that he wrote in 1975, after Aníbal Troilo died. Aníbal Troilo was his teacher, mentor, someone who helped him a lot when he moved to Buenos Aires. And he used to play with Arthur Piazzolla. He invited him into his tango orchestra. But actually, he threw him out quite fast, because Piazzolla added many stringent notes into very known tango pieces, and people refused to dance. So he was not able to play anymore. But they became very close friends. And after Aníbal Troilo died, Arthur Piazzolla wrote Sunta Troiana. And bandoneon is an instrument that Arthur Piazzolla played on, and also Aníbal. But in this very music, you can find the way of classical tango that Arthur Piazzolla heard. Second piece is Milonga del Ángel. It's a piece that is inspired by sacred things. There are many pieces like that in the music of Arthur Piazzolla, and this is one of them. Another is one of those best known pieces, Viva Tango. Arthur Piazzolla didn't like it. He wrote it, and it became very, very known and popular piece. But it was not the thing he liked. Another, the fourth piece is called Soledad, which means loneliness. This is the tango poem. This is really, really deep music about extremely deep emotions, which are actually stronger than death. And the last piece is called Concierto para Quinteto. It's a music of Arthur Piazzolla's ambitions, goals. This is the music that was one of those opus vitae of Arthur Piazzolla. You can hear there a lot of influences by all those great composers like Bela Bartok, Igor Stravinsky. But most of all, you can hear the tango, the new tango of Arthur Piazzolla.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.